James Freck, and I'm over at Charlie's house. Hey, Charlie, what's up?
Hey, how's it going, Jeff?
I hope everybody's got a friend that knows a little bit about bikes, but if you're like I was, the big deal with me was, you know, you spend, you know, a considerable amount of money, and then first off, it's being shipped in, and you've got to put it together, and man, I just, you know, all that stuff that you have to do is kind of unnerving. It really is. I don't care who you are. This is kind of scary, you know? And so I'm lucky, but I do believe it's not that difficult. We're going to find out in this unboxing. Charlie's going to do the honors, and he's going to cut this thing down and get the snips. And Charlie, do the honors. Let's get the bike out of here.
All right. Hey, Jeff, what I really like is this picture of the TV set.
Right.
And then the actual bike inlay. I thought that was creative.
It is creative. It is. Yeah, I like
that's,
that.
That's
I'm going to let you do it. Man, I'm going to stay on the camera. We're just going to go. Right. We're going to find out how.
There we go.
You know, and this bike is heavy in the box. Lifting this truck into the truck was extremely difficult. Extremely difficult. And so then you take a deep breath because you're like, oh, my gosh, did it make it through? Shipping, right? So that's the first thing you're looking at is, oh my gosh, did it make it?
Wow.
You know, the first thing they say, looks is pretty well done, doesn't it, Charlie?
It looks pretty good.
They say to take the front tire out first, right? Yeah, is that what I read? You got to have it. Well,
Oh, yeah. Yeah, there's your front tire. Here's your tire.
So there's the tire.
The fender.
And there is a fender on it. Oh, I did get the fender kit, didn't I? I didn't think it came with a front, to be real honest with you. So.
Do you mind if I just go ahead and start unpacking?
All it says is pull the box out from the instructions. Is pull that, it's got all the tools. And then if this is locked down tight, then lift it out. But
that does look pretty assembled. They do a good job up there. All right.
You got it?
Yeah, I need to do it. Ready?
Okay, yeah, let's do it. Let's pull her out. Lift.
This is the battery.
So the battery, okay.
3 amp hour battery right
yeah.
there.
So we should have one battery in it, and then we should have the second battery because I got the extended battery out of that as well.
Okay, let's get this out of the way. We'll see what they have in here.
Now, this has the extender, Charlie, which was a big draw. Very few bikes out there have a, you know, extended battery gauge. And, you know, my goal was I want a 75 miles plus. And this is supposed to do 90. So when we do more work on it, see what it really comes down at, it should be extremely interesting to see what kind of mileage or how the distance we get on this bike.
So, Jeff, here we got it looks like a rear light for
got
you.
Got a tail light.
And we got some pedals. This actually looks like a pretty nice,
for
something they're giving you. It's not a park tool, but I mean, yeah, that's not too bad. It's a nice universal three-way.
And then that would be the charger right there.
There's like, welcome to, this looks
bike
like
tricks.
And then you, all right.
You scan that in, I'm sure that's your
QR code.
Morty. Now,
that looks like something for you.
Now, you know that once that...
What I'm going to do here is just eyeball this, Jeff, and then we'll dial it in for the sake of time for the people watching.
And well, you know, I like the real time, though. You know what I'm saying? Because, you know, it's pretty easy to say, you know, what's it really going to take to do this? And I figured, Charlie, an hour is what I guesstimated it was going to take.
I think it's going to be less than that, Jeff.
Now, from what the manual said, these bolts come out.
Yeah, those will come out.
And then the bar goes in, and then you retighten that. Mechanically inclined, which I'm not, is the big fear. Now, the first main battery is here, and then your secondary battery is here, which is, and then there's my rock shock, which I was pretty stoked about, and then we'll just have to see on the front suspension how that goes. There'll be some dialing it in kind of stuff, but overall there should be a gas.
Okay, those are out. This one right here. All
And this is the Pro 3, which I haven't seen any videos on the Pro 3 yet. It's all the FS Pro 2s. But this is actually the 3 model. And pretty stoked about this.
See, a lot of times you take that off as one piece like that. You keep those together. It'll prevent it from all flopping all over the place and you're losing stuff and all that type of stuff. Just kind of set this right in here. This will go straight up here. Yeah, this is pretty well assembled, I would say.
You know,
so one of the key things here, because this is aluminum right here, so it's easy to cross thread it. If you start to put that bolt in and it's a little bit off angle and it feels not right, then it's not right. So back it off, reset it. It should slide in as easy as this is going in here. Once you cross-thread that, you're going to be out of head, you know, a stem, or you're going to take it to a shop. It's going to cost you another $30-$40 for them to work on it and get it fixed. So, and the other thing that's key right here is, you see this right here, Jeff? When we get done with that and this right down here on the bottom, they should be the same exact distance, eyeballed. You don't have to get out a measuring stick or anything like that. You want to make sure that, okay. And then what you'll do, you'll see in a second, is I'll start crossing over. Kind of like they teach you how to put on the tire. You're not just tightening down one until all the way it goes down.
So you kind of do an X pattern, is it?
Yeah, kind of X pattern. A little X pattern. Now I'm starting to snug it up. And what we'll do is we'll probably just get this tightened down first, because then we'll fit it. So you want to make sure, right, this is set up from the factory. You want to make sure it's set up to your desire. If you want a little bit rotated front or back, I'm going to do it just about right there.
You know, while he's tightening out, a little bit about what the whole deal was with me on this bike. I'm a bike guy and I've been in the bike business all my life. I love motorcycles. I wanted to get a bike to do the adventures that we do. You know, and to throw it on the back of this truck right here. And thank God, look how cool that is. I can't wait to get pictures of both of them, the silver, right? Matching silver, basically. But I didn't want to get another motorcycle. I wanted to get a bike, but my biggest fear was that, was it going to be able to haul the stuff I wanted? Was it going to be able to go at a speed at which I, you know, because I go back and we do a lot of ruins and things like that. So we're in some extreme terrains. And I wanted a bike, and when this one came out with a full suspension, and it has the extra battery on it, and it has all the components that's going to ride, you know, to me, this is like a middle ground for a guy like me of a motorcycle versus a bicycle. And so I think I've got the best of both worlds, and I can't wait to get it out there and really see. Now, I did upgrade the brakes, as you see, right here, because I know from my other bike. Now, what did I do? I went and bought a cheap Chinese bike that I, you know, and I actually love that bike because that was the gateway drug to get me in, because there's no way I was going to spend the kind of money it was going to take to get a quality bike. But once I got that bike and I found out how fun it is, I was like, I have to get a bike. And so I was willing then to spend the money. But if I wouldn't have got that cheap bike, and you know, the brakes are horrible and all the things you think about some of the Chinese bikes, but it still is a ton of fun. And you know, if you're not committed to do that, then it definitely is hard to spend the money until you know you're getting what you want. I'm pretty impressed with this, Charlie.
Yeah, it looks sharp. I like it.
And then the big Bafang motor. You know, one of the things that they talk about on this is that you need to upgrade the hub, because, you know, this hub, the basic hubs were built for basically pedal power. So now that you've jacked up, you've got this kind of torque that you have on this motor, that's why you want to make sure that you upgrade your hubs. Now, that's what I was told. I don't know yet because I haven't been down that road. I wanted a mid-hub, though. I wanted a mid-drive motor. And why would I want that? Because now you use the gears. The bike I have now has a hub on it, hub motor, which I like, but you don't really even need the drive system. With this, you know, this is my motorcycle where I'm going to be able to use the gears as low, high, and I'm going to be able to shift this bike like a motorcycle. But, you know, it's going to be quiet, it's going to be efficient, and the fact that they say the range is 90 miles, that's going to get me to places like the Road of the Devil. Charlie likes that. And Charlie's going to be just, he's going to be pedaling, but... Okay, yeah?
All right.
So, you're just tightening down this right here.
Yeah, I'm just snugging these up right here. I've already tightened both these bolts right here for your through, and then... Just gonna snug these up. I used to have a it was called a free ride bike, kind of a downhill bike, and it had this same exact setup. It seems like if you get the bigger forks that are taking a pounding, it'll have like a through bolt here, through axle, and then you got these down here that even give it more support on the through. Let's get these pedals on. Now, these are your stock pedals. And that's probably like a 15.
Yeah, it says left and right on it.
Yeah, they say left and right, and it's probably a 15 millimeter.
Now, when they say left or right, Charlie, is that you sitting on the bike is your left?
Yeah, as you're sitting on the bike, your left.
Okay.
I'm going to bring out my old school BMX when I used to race BMX in the 70s, late 70s to date me. And you just,
that's, I will tell you,
Phil's waterproof grease. I don't know if you've ever seen it. Yeah. So you just don't want those things seizing because they can be a pain in the rear end to get off. All right. I got that on there. Bingo. Got a mess in my garage here. And then, which one is this? This is... That was a great thing to point out there, Jeff, since you've replaced your pedals recently, is there is a right and a left threaded. Huh? Right? And that's your left. I don't have my glasses on. That might help.
Well, this is real life, too. This is not like somebody at the factory that's put 1,000 bikes together, right?
W left and W right.
Okay.
WR. Okay. So we're going to stay with the left here. I'll get that. Just run it in like so. All right, here we go. Can I do it by hand? There we go. See? Again, nothing should be forced. This is aluminum right here. You can see how it all, you can spin it in by hand because these bearings aren't really loose right there. Boom, spin it right in by hand. And these don't have to be super over tight. You can see I'm just gonna go down like this and I'm just gonna snug it. Zip you. With my 15 millimeter, boom, just snug it up. I'm kind of eyeballing this. I know you looked at the instructions, but this is pretty darn easy to put together, not even looking at instructions or watching a video or anything. All right, that looks like how it fits. Now, in here, Jeff, you said there was... Oh, right here. No, that's the battery, right?
I wonder if there's any of these boxes that we...
Oh, here we go. Here we go. Right here.
And that looks pretty simple. Just looks like those four go right into the... pretty self-explanatory how that works. And again, importance for me and what I do is that I have a rack to be able to haul the equipment that I need to haul in, you know, my camera stuff and all that kind of stuff. So this is, you know, this bike is, was built specifically for a purpose, and that is to do exploration and things like that. And this bike gets me to where I'm going to hike when we go to the cliff dwellings, for example. And then when I get home, you know, when I get ready to go home, you know, I have to haul stuff. So that's the only reason it was, you know, this was very important that, you know, we had the different, the rack on the back and things like that, even though I think it looks a lot cooler without it. It's not about the cool factor looking, even though they did a great job matching this stuff.
All right. So what you're going to find when you open this up, Jeff, is you're going to find four hex key, looks like shorter ones. This is great because half the people aren't even going to read the instructions. Can you see those four? Those are going to be for those four piece screws for right. The back rack.
Well, you know, I didn't even plan on getting a front fender, to be honest with you. That was just part of the package when you got this rear rack. But I will tell you, if I'm in the mud, like I think I'm going to be in the mud, I might not be mad.
So, when you're bombing through the desert on this, Jeff, I can tell you that a lot of these bolts are going to be coming loose. So maintenance, which we should probably do a something on the beginners of maintenance of what you need to do with these bikes.
Now we're just these four bolts right in, right? So there we are. That is real time right there. You know, every one of these are going to be like unique to, you know, to each and every one of us, because even the, you know, the buff marks and all that's going to be completely unique to everybody that that rides it.
That's it. This is a mean machine.
This is right there.
You're 6'2"?
Well, 6'1" now.
6'1", what's your inseam in your leg?
32.
Okay, so you got a long leg.
And so you're still up on this thing, so.
Man, that's like Motorcycle Jeff right there, man, on an e-bike.
Yeah, I can't deal with that.
Well, for you, you're probably used to sitting up higher if you're used to riding motorcycles.
Yeah, let's get it out without any, I can't wait to have something to see how bad it is just to pedal. Oh man, that really is not bad.
Oh, this is your adventure rig, right?
This is an adventure. This is totally to get out in it and haul my gear and get me 30 miles in without beating the truck to death, you know, and that's the deal too. And being efficient like a motorcycle, because you can fly on a bike. So, but this is going to be quiet and easy, you know, and I couldn't be happier.